Hey there, Marcus Bronzy here from How to Kill an Hour. I just thought I'd drop you a quick line to say, hey, thank you for supporting the podcast. Myself and the whole team really appreciate it. And we've decided to give back, and we've done that via our Patreon, which is a great way for you to show us a little bit of love by supporting us and becoming a patron of the show. And in return, we will give you extra episodes that we only give to our patrons. Plus, on top of that, you get all of the content that we deliver on our free feed earlier than usual and ad-free. Because, well, why are we going to make you listen to ads if you've just helped us out by giving a little to us? So here's a little taster of what you can expect on our Patreon feed. Today's episode starts with an email. That email was sent to German YouTuber and journalist Mirko Drotschmann. Mirko's YouTube channel has a healthy following of 1.5 million. And the content it covers, as described by Mirko himself, is
exciting general knowledge about politics, history and current affairs, sometimes with an opinion. The opinion expressed in my videos is private and has nothing to do with my employees and clients.
Which makes the content of the email that he received even more weird. When you have an audience the size of his, you should expect to be approached by companies wishing to access our audience, well, your audience, with an advertising campaign, right? Makes sense, Nick, innit? He's got 500,000 followers. People want to get involved in that.
That's what happens, mate, you know?
Brand deals.
Cash money.
But I think because of the nature of his content, Mirko normally ignores offers from brands asking them to advertise his products, because advertising in politics, it can get a bit murky, can't it, quite easily. And he sounds like somebody who wants to keep quite morally neutral.
Yeah, it can get a bit Mirko. You get it? That's shocking.
Kill me, please. But the sponsorship offer he received in May 2021, it was unique. It was from an influencer marketing agency called Faz. And they were offering to pay him to promote what it said was leaked information that suggested the death rate among people who had Pfizer was almost 3 times that of those that had the AstraZeneca jab.
Hold on. This better not be true.
After you brag about your trouble.
After I'm like, yeah, I got a good stuff, mate. Pfizer in the arm. 3 times more likely. Fucking hell, mate. Jesus.
You've gone from a smug chap to the opposite, Nick. Fucking hell, should have had that AstraZeneca as well, mate.
Should have had that Moderna, mate. You know, get that in there.
Moderna. Remember that? That sounds like an old school throwback now.
Well, everyone's calling the Moderna the hipster jab because, like, hardly anybody's getting it. Because, like, most places do Astra or Pfizer. And, yeah. Like, I know a few people that have had Moderna, and it's, like, the hipster jab of choice.
Are they the person at the party sipping port going, yeah, so I actually had Moderna.
Yeah, Moderna, know? Darling. Yes, they offered me that Pfizer stuff, but I thought it was too commercial. Far too many people were having it.
Yes. You know, I like to make my own choices when it comes to vaccines. Thank you very much. Now, the fact that the death rate amongst people that take the Pfizer vaccine is almost 3 times that of the AstraZeneca jab, well, that is a fact that is simply not true. But it gets a little bit weirder, because the company that was speaking to him did a few things that brands do not usually do. Apparently, they were quite braggadocious about how much money they had, which is not something that big companies do. Usually, when you have a big company trying to do ads, here's how it works. The big company hires an ad agency and gives them a budget and tries to squeeze as much advertising out of that budget as they can.
Action!
We'd like to accept your offer to advertise for our marketing campaign, Bright Advertising Limited. Us here at Bronzy Co. turned over 100 million last year.
100 million, man. Yeah. That's so cool, dude. Because I work in advertising. I don't really care about anything, man, as you can tell, dude. Like, I just like taking lewds and just like getting out of my mind. Yeah. That's how I come up with all these ads. But yeah. 100 million you made. 100. Oh, okay, right. Yeah. So I'm gonna need at least half of that for the advertising campaign, man. I'm gonna need like 50 M's.
Allocated advertising.
It should be nothing, you know.
Well, I
50 M's, you know. I mean,
well, you keep saying 50 M's to me, but, you know, whilst I say we turned over 100 M, when you look at the forecasts for the next 14 months and having me forward, our advertising budget is looking more like £30.
30 pounds.
Yep.
30. I mean, what the fuck is this, man? Like, you made 100 M's or not? It sounds like you're talking shit, man. If you want the great adverts made by the greatest creative mind, mine, then you're going to have to pay the money.
Okay, look, I'll tell you what. Because I like your T-shirt that says you've had the Moderna jab. You're so out there, aren't you? I can tell you're out there with that T-shirt. Yeah. Did you actually have it as well?
Moderna only.
So, yeah,
I didn't get the jab.
You just got the T-shirt, not the jab.
I mean, that's what other cool kids are doing.
Okay.
You have no idea.
Okay. I clearly have no. That's why you're in advertising, not. But because I like you, I'll tell you what, £50.
Yes, £50 done.
That's a very exaggerated example of how brands work. I mean, even your biggest brands in the world, they're not just going to give you an open checkbook and be like, "Yeah, crack on." But Mirko was really surprised.
I thought that was pretty accurate.
Yeah, pretty slight on the entertainment industry. Oh yeah. So brands don't usually work like that. Say, "Hi, we're rich. Do you want to advertise something for us on YouTube?" It's very odd. But Mirko was also provided with a weird set of instructions.
Number one, do not use words advertising, sponsored video, etc. in your post stories and videos. They should look like an advice to the audience.
For starters, before you even go further, that's super illegal. That is like the what
super first, against the, yeah.
Yeah, that's the first thing that you shouldn't do when you're doing hashtag ads. Right, sorry.
Number two, present the material natively. Act like you have the passion and interest in this topic. Present the material as your own independent view. Number three, make the main conclusion from the table. Explain them with expression. The death rate amongst the vaccinated by Pfizer is almost 3 times higher than among the vaccinated by AstraZeneca. Number four, tell that the mainstream media ignores this theme and you decided to share it with your subscriber. Number five, put a question like, why some governments actively purchasing Pfizer vaccine, which is dangerous to health of the people? The English in this is absolutely shocking. It took me 17 attempts to read that because there's words missing and fucking words in the wrong place. If I got that straight away, I'll be like, you lot are fucking cowboys, mate. There's no way I'm putting any of this shit on my social media.
This reeks of dodginess, doesn't it? Like the lack of spelling. I mean, saying one, don't use advertising when you're using an ad. That's like illegal in any form of advertising to be like, this isn't an ad when it is. Present the material natively. So like, act like you have a genuine interest in it, right? I guess that's cool with advertising. When you're advertising something, you know, if someone's talking about washing their hair with Head and Shoulders, they're not going to be like, well, I hate washing my hair, but when I have to, I use Head and Shoulders. I get that. That's cool. Like,
well, I've had like a number of these proposals before, not for anti-vaxxing, just for like random
for Moderna
stuff on my social media. And yeah. And, they do say like, you know, oh, you can put it into your own words. They normally give you like a suggested tweet or whatever, but like if nobody's going to, in fact, some of the big people do it because they can't be asked to change it, but I just think it's just whack. So I always like change it and if it's something I'm interested in, it's much easier. But you still have to put all like the hashtag ad and all of that crap, man. You can't just be like, yeah, man, I really love this thing. It's sick. Mm. And then like nothing. You can get shit for that.
Exactly. Well, look, and they also told him to tell them that the mainstream media ignores this whole thing and put a question in there like, why is the government actively purchasing this Pfizer vaccine? Well, they're also, this is all weird. Alarm bells are ringing for me and Nick at this point, and it also was for Mirko. But they're also adamant that the company that they were working with wanted to stay incognito as well. Could you imagine that, Nick? Nick, we want you to advertise something, but we aren't going to tell you who's backing it. That's weird as well, isn't it?
It already sounds dodge.
Yeah, yeah. Mirko shared these weird messages on Twitter, and he said, and this is a translation from Twitter, by the way, because he didn't write this in English.
It's strange. Received a partnership proposal which consists of breaking down the Pfizer vaccine on video. Colossal budget. Client who wants to remain incognito, and you have to hide the sponsorship. If you see any videos of it, you'll know it's an op.
Yeah, it's an op, yeah?
I know, that sounds... I mean,
took it
for those that don't know, op, yeah, op is used as slang as basically like an enemy.
Yeah, yeah.
Yo, bro, if you see any enemy, you know it's an op, yeah?
I think he means it's an operation, maybe. He then said this.
I know this is bread and butter for conspirators, but hey, it seems important to me to show that your favorite YouTubers / TikTokers can be the spokespersons for what appear to be a trade dispute in this specific case. In brackets, I guess.
So he thought at this point this could be like a trade dispute between two brands, like, you know, a Coke and a Pepsi or a Pfizer and an AstraZeneca trying to clash each other and get like more people using their jab. But I mean... Man, alarm bells are ringing. This weird set of instructions that are really badly spelt. Somebody's saying, I got loads of cash. Yeah, I got loads of cash. You got to do this. I'll make you loads of money, but I can't tell you who it's for. At this point...
These people sound like the only fours and horses of the vaccine world. Like, I got a suitcase full of cash. I'll make you a millionaire, mate. The only thing is, it's not strictly kosher, you know? Yeah. It's not strictly 100%. So, you know, you got to keep it off the social media.
Yeah.
Especially the ad stuff. We don't want any of that on there, all right? You got to make it sound like, you know, we're being completely genuine. We're not really completely operating within the lines of the law. But hey, who is? You know what I mean? You want to be rich? You want this money? Just do what we say.
Exactly. And when we say a case full of cash, do you mind getting paid in bread? Like actual loaves of bread? Yeah? You've got £100 million worth of bread. It's all yours, mate. All yours. Goes off next week, but...
To be fair, there's loads of dough in bread. You know what I mean?
At the same time as Mirko was receiving this offer, so was the YouTuber Leo Grasset, aka Dirty Biology. His channel bio says, and by the way, this is another Google translation.
Science videos on mindfuck, dirty, or just funny topics. Sometimes we talk about biology too.
Yeah, I think...
That sounds like porn.
Yeah. I think what he's trying to say is like he makes videos that blow your mind about biology that are sometimes a bit left, a bit right, a bit filthy. I didn't see many dirty or just funny topics. Saw a couple of mindfuck on there, but you know, I think he just means blow your mind about biology. Anyway, the same company, Faz, offered him a big 2,000 euros. Fucking hell. Yeah, we're fucking loaded, mate. We're loaded. 2,000 euros? Yeah, we're massive. £2,000 asked him if he would take part in the same campaign, saying that they wanted him to, quote,
act like you have the passion and interest in this topic.
Faz again said it was acting for a client who wished to remain anonymous, which Leo said was a huge red flag. Huge. But the more that they probed, the more funky this campaign sounded. They were also told not to mention the video had a sponsor and instead pretend that they were spontaneously given advice out of concern for their viewers. There you go. That's a little taster of what you can get when you're listening to the patron-only episodes of How to Kill an Hour. If you are still only dedicated to our free feed, that's fine. There's plenty there for you to enjoy and kill time with. And if you do want to show us a little bit of love and in return for that, get bonus episodes that are only for patrons and, of course, all of our regular content without ads, then feel free to click the link in the show description or just head to patreon.com/howtokillanhour. Anyway, I'll be in the ear holes real soon. See you next time.